justification for the disruption, which it says will hit the cities most vulnerable the hardest. It's really unnecessary. I don't think it's fair on the claimants. I don't think it's fair on the women. You know, they'll lose pay over the next couple of days, those who are not going to work, who are going to go out on strike. And there is going to be enormous disruption caused in Glasgow and to some of the vulnerable people in the city.
The council says it's committed to making an offer to those on strike. It's not been really clear how they'll settle the bill, which could run to hundreds of millions of pounds. But those looking for equal pay say time's run out to recognise the true value of their job, and they must now pay up. Gordon, BBC News, Glasgow.
Well, it is hard to see where this dispute goes from here. The leader of Glasgow City Council says she's entirely on the side of the women taking action, and she's determined that a meaningful offer is on the table soon. But the unions say no serious negotiations have yet taken place. As to the women taking part in this action, that they tell me they're upset that they're on strike, but they say
this is the most points of his presidency. Donald Trump is deploying exceptionally divisive rhetoric, painting his opponents not just as a threat to the country, but as a disloyal and radical form. James Cook, BBC News, Houston.
The allegation of contempt of court against the former leader of the far-right English Defence League, Tommy Robinson, is being referred to the Attorney General. Mr. Robinson appeared at the Old Bailey this morning to face an allegation that he'd committed contempt by filming people before a criminal trial. The time is 1:15. Our top story this lunchtime. The Turkey president says there is strong evidence that the Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi was savagely murdered in a planned operation. Come on the programme, Mysteries of the Deep. Researchers discover the oldest intact shipwreck a mile down in the Black Sea.
And a look left in 15 minutes. Yorkshire's addiction to fast food. BBC research shows there's been a huge rise in the number of takeaways in our region. And after attracting more than 2 million views online, a man's emotional cricket-themed eulogy for his father is shortlisted for an award.
The longest sea bridge in the world has been opened by the Chinese President Xi
Even like mac and cheese.